seems to be the emergency. Speak up, will you? I couldn't hear a single word you said. Well, so my suspicions were correct. We do have a little thief among the maids. Surely it was the one that I had been warning you of. Oh? And how about the one that they talk to all the time? Surely they would be in on it as well. That is interesting. Who is it, if you do not mind me asking such a question? Excuse me? What do you mean? They were the only person that I wouldn't suspect doing such a thing. I refuse to believe it. Bring them to me. I will have this discussion with them. Thank you. Now, before she gets here, I would very much appreciate some tea, if you will. Perfect. Thank you very much. They're already on their way here. You're always one step in front of me. I'm not sure if I should see that as a good thing or a bad thing. Perhaps later, I'll ponder it. Oh, I also need you to bring some hors d'oeuvres. Actually, as a matter of fact, it is around that time, so have the cooks prepare some lunch and meet me outside by the rose garden. Perhaps when they're away from the others, they will be able to talk more and express who really was the thief. I still don't see them as the type of person that would steal things lying about. I find this all a bit strange. No matter, do as I asked and we won't have a problem. Other than the immediate issue, is there anything else that seems to be the matter? You also have witnesses that'll testify that they've been doing it for quite some time. Now that, I'm not sure of. I believe people say a lot of things. I would rather speak with her before we immediately jump to conclusions now. After all, we don't need any miscommunications here. Thank you so much for joining me. Would you like some tea? I'm sure that you would love it. It's from some faraway land that you've more than likely never heard of. No tea? Very well. I'm not going to push. Are you at all hungry? I can have the cooks prepare a nice meal and... How you're acting makes me wonder if you know the exact reason you're here. I can see you're the type of person who doesn't wish to waste time. So then, shall we immediately get into it? Take a seat then. Something tells me this conversation won't exactly take a few minutes. There's a fire in your eye, something that I haven't noticed before. Perhaps I've done something wrong, and if I have, I would very much appreciate you telling me. That way, I get at least an inclination of what your feelings are towards me. I'm selfish. I believe that's the first time say that about me. If anything, they say I'm the opposite. Why would you think I'm selfish? I give you a room, food, medical attention when needed. That doesn't exactly say selfish now, does it? What about the village? Of course I don't know what you're talking about. If I had, I would. Everyone is dismissed. I wish to speak with them alone. It would be best to do this without an audience. Now, tell me about this village. I see. Strange. So, from what I understand, you stole valuables for the village. Playing hero, and yet you're the villain in this story. That wouldn't be a bad story if you ask me. How are you the villain? Are you genuinely asking me such a question? Very well. I suppose I can at least entertain you for a moment. You're the villain because you are still a thief, even if you don't see yourself as one. You have stolen right below one's nose and claim that you're a hero. Some people may praise you, while others may cringe at your very name. Unfortunately, that's simply how the world works. And who knows? Maybe I wasn't made aware of such a thing happening due to the fact that I send them supplies every 2 weeks. Perhaps if you look at it a different way, if I knew that there were problems with this, maybe you had made the issues worse by giving these said supplies to the real villains of the story. How would you feel about that then? And now the gears are beginning to turn. Mir, you had me pictured as a selfish ruler. No, I suppose some may see me that way. I believe I am not such a word in any shape or form. But you got the picture after speaking with me. I believe this is your second time, if I'm not mistaken. Indeed, you, out of all people, should know never to judge a book by its cover. It may just hold the best of stories. And now you're beginning to think. Perfect. That's exactly what I've been wanting you to do. Now, how about the state of the village? If you don't mind sharing, of course. From what people have told me, they are thriving. But how you had to steal from the rich and give to the poor tells me otherwise. No need to speak so fast. We won't get interrupted. And if we do, I'll just dismiss them. Take your time, so I know what you're saying. Now that's very... Well, I never heard of such a thing. So you're telling me that the village is being controlled by another power besides my own? When did you notice such a thing? I think I know what's been going on here. It's such a common thing, and yet most people in my place more than likely wouldn't have guessed, or at least never wanted to, for that matter. My people would likely never suspect you telling me all this, and for that, I wish for you to go about your day as usual. What am I going to do? I'm going to think about this and figure out the best way to go about it. After all, I can't let who I believe is in charge of all this know I know about the information you just shared. That's the last thing I need right now. Do you have to leave? You don't have to stay. But if anything, I believe I would enjoy the company. But of course, we may not be able to stay for long, because the clouds are beginning to darken, and I've heard of a few terrible storms coming about a few days ago. Are you scared of thunder? My goodness, you answered fast. So I'm going to take the words that you've just told me as a lie. I was asking a simple question. I believe that's how getting to know one another works, if I'm not mistaken. Am I scared of thunder? No. Because it's beautiful. It's like the clouds are singing their very own songs. Sure, at some moments it could be deafening, while at others it's as silent as the rain. Just imagine closing your eyes and peacefully listening to the rain. It's something very beautiful. Why are you looking at me like that? I was only explaining my point of view on the rain. Surely now you can see how much I enjoy it. I must be honest. I don't know how much longer I'm able to stay out here. As much as I enjoy the rain, I don't want to risk a fever. Would you care to join me in my study? We could talk more over some tea, if you would prefer such a thing. Good. Very good. Now, come along. Hey there. It's me, the voice behind the screen. I'm glad you made it to the end of the video. If you enjoyed this audio and want to listen to more like it, could you please do me a big favor and watch another one of my videos? Growing as a small channel on YouTube is difficult, and every view helps. Thank you so much for choosing to listen to me, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.